Meet Pear and Christelle. They are working to cut carbon dioxide, or CO2 emissions, from the cement industry. Using capture technology, specialist ships, and undersea storage. Because while cement helps build the world around us, homes and offices, bridges and canals, roads and runways, the cement industry emits up to 7% of all carbon dioxide emissions globally. So, Northern Lights, a partnership between Shell, Equinor and TotalEnergies, supported by the Norwegian government, has come up with a way to help customers, like Heidelberg Cement, cut them.
I feel we have a huge responsibility as one of the big emitters, but also for me as a person.
This is Per Brevik of Norcem, Norway's biggest cement producer and part of Heidelberg Cement Group. At their Brevik plant, he's the man with a CO2 capture plan.
We will capture 400,000 tons, which is 50% of our emissions.
That's 400,000 tons of CO2 emissions per year.
Cement starts with a lump of rock, limestone. And it's quite a process going from this to this.
It sure is. To make cement, limestone must be crushed and baked at up to 6 times the heat of a pizza oven, which splits it into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide.
This process, this split, is unavoidable. We haven't found another way to do it without CO2 emissions.
So, to stop this CO2 being emitted into the atmosphere, Per and his colleagues have come up with a clever plan.
We are building a new plant aside the cement plant where we are going to take out the CO2.
And this is the technology behind it. The CO2 emissions from the factory will be diverted into a processing unit where the CO2 molecules are absorbed by a liquid. Next, steam separates the CO2 from this liquid before the CO2 is compressed at high pressure, liquefying it, ready for transport.
After we have captured and conditioned the CO2, we have done our part of the work.
This is where Northern Lights will come in, pumping the liquid CO2 onto a ship and sailing it around the coast of Norway for permanent storage. Enter Christelle Lampton, Technical Director of the Northern Lights joint venture.
So here we are at the building site of the receiving terminal for Northern Lights, where the captured CO2 is being delivered into temporary storage tank.
From these storage tanks, the liquid CO2 will travel 100 kilometers through an undersea pipeline, where it will be injected 2.6 kilometers below the seabed and stored permanently in a rock formation.
The capacity of the phase one of Northern Lights is 1.5 million tons per year. With demand growing, we will expand the terminal capacity of between 6 and 7 million tons per year. And this will hopefully provide a storage solution for other industries like steel, waste incineration, chemicals.
By capturing the CO2, we can produce low carbon products and we will contribute to a low carbon economy based on sustainability.